guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So we're gonna be continuing where we left off in Outlast, which from what I remember is trying to turn on the power. Gotta try and remember some of these buttons. We're gonna hide this pretty scary stuff. If I remember, this is the guy with the bat. One violent guy, huh? I think I got the power back on, but I'm a little bit scared.
Hello, doctor.
sure heard us. Okay, here he comes. Just hope he doesn't check this locker. Yeah, I know for sure he heard me activate that, so just trying to make sure that he doesn't still see me. He hasn't checked this corner yet, so I'm hoping that this isn't one that he's in. Gonna reload the battery so that way I don't have to worry about it here. We're gonna go back in there, we're gonna try and hit that main switch if it's activated. If not, then we're gonna just continue to hide. I'm not gonna lie, this is a little bit scary. So running is kind of my only tactic, the only thing I can think of. I have no idea where to go. I have to find another valve. Thank you. Outcast. I feel like that is all the excitement I can take. I feel like getting the power back on is definitely a good place to leave it, but oh my god, that was terrifying. I have never felt like I've had to run that fast in my life. Holy. Okay, but before we go, we're going to go ahead and read through this document that we picked up while we were down there. So, Hypnotic Experimentation and Research, February 10th, 1954. On Wednesday, 10th February 1954, hypnotic experimentation and research work was continued in building 13 of the Mount Massive Preserve in Colorado using the following subjects. Material bridged. A post-hypnotic of the night before, pointed finger, you will sleep, was enacted. Mrs. Jackson and Pierce immediately progressed to a deep hypnotic state with no further suggestion. Miss Pierce was then instructed, having previously expressed a fear of firearms in any fashion, that she would use every method at her disposal to awaken Miss Jackson. Now in a deep hypnotic sleep, in failing this, she would pick up a nearby pistol and fire it at Miss Jackson. She was instructed that her rage would be so great that she would not hesitate to kill Jackson for failing to awaken. Miss Pierce carried out these suggestions to the letter, including firing the unloaded pneumatic pistol gun at Jackson and then proceeding to fall into a deep sleep. After proper suggestions were made, both were awakened and expressed complete amnesia for the entire sequence. Miss Pierce was again handed the gun, which she refused in an awakened state to pick up or accept from the operator. She expressed absolute denial that the foregoing sequence had happened. Interesting. So, we know that they were experimenting on the patients, and now we know that they were doing some kind of hypnotic experimentation as well. So, that's kind of interesting. I guess we can definitely continue to see where the story goes from here. I'm excited to see you guys next time. Go ahead and leave a like, comment, maybe subscribe as well. And you guys have a wonderful day. Bye.